Pulse. And right here, you know, you have the game on the line. You know what West Virginia can do when they have the football. Line up and challenge them. Quarterback sneak.
And there it is. And it looks like you got enough. Just straight ahead for James Pickney.
You coach against me, just know. Fourth down and an inch, I'm going to call the quarterback sneak.
And why not? It works.
Right here, you just see James Pinckney right here. Get in behind those big grunts and get some push. He's a big, strong quarterback, 6'3", 220, good body lean. Moving the chain.
You have the veterans, Matt Butler, 68, Eric Graham, 78, over there on that side, along with his center, Wiggenbach. They let it, and he gets the first down at 10. They are in West Virginia territory. Looking deep, wants to throw the ball over there to wide open at the 20-yard line, and down to 21 with a first down.
Boy, what
a 21-yard gain.
The pocket presence of James Pinckney. He gets pressure from the outside. The throwing lane is in the middle. He steps up. Watch it right here. This is operating. No pressure from the outside. I'm going to step up into it and then hit my tight end, Devon Drew, for a first down, who happened to be a former quarterback. They got him loaded. Matt Dosh was a former quarterback. Devon Drew. Bunch of them. You know, quarterbacks are athletic.
Yeah. Devon Drew with his eighth reception of the year and his first of the day. Heisman Trophy winner quarterback, Andre Ware. Looking downfield again in the middle. That's deflected, incomplete, and almost intercepted. John Holmes involved after it was tipped by Jay Henry. Delighted to have you with us. College football and a good one. West Virginia, the number 4 team in the nation. We're in Greenville, North Carolina. I'm Gary Thorne with Andre Ware and Todd Harris. About a 3-touchdown favorite, West Virginia. It has not been that kind of game. They've got a 17-7 lead. But this Pirate team from East Carolina has hung tough. West Virginia is expected. You see the plays and time. They've got that. But the yardage, not that much of a differential. And especially the West Virginia running game's been held down. A second down and 10 out of the shotgun. Pinckney looking. Big rush. Dumps it off. Great pass. 25, first down, inside the 10.
What?
That is Philip Henry, but James Pinckney made that as he was getting hit.
Yeah, he took a big-time shot, and that is courage to stand in there. As a quarterback, you know that you're going to catch one in the chops every now and then. And right here, he knows he's going to get hit, and it's the tail end of that, but I'm going to stand in, throw an accurate ball to my receiver, Philip Henry, who has made play after play for this East Carolina offense.
That was Craig Wilson for West Virginia, who came in and put the hit on. Now it is going to be a first and goal. That is going to be Henry's fifth reception,
like
50 yards.
They're like a bad itch. They just won't go away with it.
Right now, they're a little more than that even for West Virginia, I think. All right, it is first down and goal. Pinckney again looking over the middle. Big rush gets hit. Did he fumble? I think he did. That ball is loose, free and available. No, incomplete pass. A late call made. Johnny Dingle, the defensive end, put the hit on, but Pinckney twice now slammed.
Well, I tell you, this was close. He was trying to get it out of there. It looked like it may have pulled it back, but I think it's a good call by the official right here. He's trying to get rid of it, trying to throw it. It comes out, and East Carolina escapes right there.
You want a review on that?
Not if I'm East Carolina.
Oh, understandably so.
I think I get out of that huddle and get a play call.
That's right. Boy, that was close. Maybe a break right there. West Virginia leads at 17-7, under 14 to go here.
Well, they got a good matchup right here.
Again, comes to the near side. They assigned, tried to run the ball. Remember, they got a score here. And out of bounds, Brandon Frasch is at about the 8-yard line.
Well,
after losing yardage, they don't get much here either.
Now, this is playing right into the hands of a fast, quick West Virginia defense. They want you to string the football out, and they play from inside out. They keep good outside leverage, forcing things, holding you up, and then let all the other playmakers show up to make plays. Larry Williams and a host of Mountaineers showing up there.
Well, it is a third down and goal. Ball is at the 9-yard line. 3-for-8 and third down conversions. 5 receivers looking into the middle. The end zone incomplete. He was wide open. Philip Henry was open in the end zone, and that ball had some mustard on it, and he couldn't hang on to it.
I'll tell you what happened. James Pinckney was ready to go there, and Philip Henry wasn't ready for the football. Right there. Little mustard on it. Right there. Those you have to catch. Those are why you're in the starting lineup. Those are why you're on the field every Saturday, because you make those plays in practice. You got to translate and make them on Saturdays.
So it'll be a 26-yard field goal attempt that importantly will cut this lead to 7. Lee is out. Snap down and a good one. The kick is up, and it is good. So there's plenty of time left for East Carolina. The field goal brings them within a touchdown against number 4 ranked West Virginia.
Yeah, they mentioned that last week, the turf toe, and we hadn't seen him in this ball game quite some time. 2 playmakers.
That's taken deep in the end zone by Renault. He's the great runner who returned one last week. He gets bumped with a shoulder at the 25-yard line.
Aspect of the game that goes very, very under the radar.
Quentin Cotton is back in. So is Steve Slayton. Slayton has come into play. That'll be to the 30, 35, 36-yard line. That is Steve Slayton's game here. And right now it's ball control for West Virginia. They want to score, and they want to take a lot of time doing it. Patrick White at quarterback leading this offense, their outstanding sophomore. Hands off again. Slayton on the carry, straight ahead, 40-yard line. Or he is down. That is Van Eskridge, who moved in after he got a 5-yard gain. Slayton, unbelievable. He is their fastest player. After they won the Sugar Bowl last year over Georgia, they went back home and they had a race. All the guys said, all right, everybody claims to be the fastest. Let's have a 60-yard dash. And that's what they did. And Slayton ran the 60 in 6 seconds.
Wow.
Faster than anybody else on the team.
Now he's kind of been held in check there. Only 83 yards, he and Chris Johnson. And only 5 carries for Chris Johnson on it. They just couldn't go on that toe.
East Carolina defense has done a job. That's Slayton again. One to beat. Not going to do it. Fine play made on the corner to take him down by Kyle Chase. Chase has had a heck of a game for East Carolina.
Well, now you see Pat White under the center. They want to run some clock, maybe run the football, go into the I formation with Steve Slayton. Going to try to chew some of this clock now. Just a little above 12 minutes left in this football game, but Rich Rodriguez recognizes, I got a lead. I got a hungry football team on the other side. I better get rid of some of this time.
Clock ticking away here as they have a second down at the 40-yard line. 2 receivers to the near side. Second down and 10. The lefty comes to the near side on that little flat pattern. It's caught at the 50-yard line. Look out here. The 40. Nobody in front of him. Down to the 20. The 10. The 5. Touchdown. Renard.
Well, that's the play that if you're East Carolina, you cannot afford to have happen. They've got playmakers everywhere, and this time they chose Darius Renard. Right here, nice little screen play. You see the offensive lineman get out in front and block him down the field, and all of a sudden it's just his ability to run with the football after the catch in open space, and he's got speed. I bet you he wasn't very far behind Slayton in that 60-meter race.
His second touchdown, receiving-wise, a 60-yard touchdown pass. The extra point kick by Pat McAfee is up, and it is good. And there is the big play of the ball game. Renard's 60-yard TD pass, his 5th catch. He's got 110 yards on the day. 24-10. Scrimmage this year for West Virginia, and what a big play it was. Patrick White now 15 for 22, passing 200 yards, 2 TDs, 3 interceptions.
And you know, he just has that cool demeanor. He and Slayton, best of friends, but he is, I mean, just never really seems to get too excited, too high, too low after an interception. Always kind of even keel about him, and that's what you need from a leader at the quarterback position. He didn't get too excited after that big run. He's happy for his teammate, but he realizes we'll celebrate on the bus on the way to the airport.
And only a sophomore who had 5 starts last year, taking up the line of scrimmage to the 15. East Carolina's offense has to do it again. That is Hewitt, and he got smacked on that one, shy of the 20-yard line. Todd Harris.
Well, if you take a close look at Coach Skip Holt's left wrist, he wears a wristband similar to the Lance Armstrong Livestrong bands, but this one is purple. It says Pirate Nation. And part of Coach Holt's project here is getting the spirits, the attitude of Pirate Nation up. He even has kids over to the house on Thursday, not an NCAA violation, and they make dinner, and he's just trying to get the camaraderie. A lot of the players told me, you know, in the past, there were cliques on the team. Guys would hang their heads if we got down. He says, now it's a team effort. We win together. We lose together. This would be an important drive if they can get this thing pulled off.
Pitney will roll it out to the far side over the middle, incomplete, going for Andre Allison. Allison's had a tough day today, their leading receiver. Pinckney has gone 14 out of 26, 186 yards, one interception, and one touchdown pass.
Yeah, his wife, Coach Holtz, his wife came in yesterday in the meetings and brought some Pirate Crunch. I mean, it was very, very tasty.
Pirate Crunch has made all meetings and is downstairs in our production truck for the game.
She's got a friend for life with me with that stuff.
All right, it brings up a second down and 10, 11 minutes to go in the football game in East Carolina. They've got time, but they've got to move in this offensive series. Pinckney on the handoff, straight ahead off the left side, maybe a yard or two, but that's going to be that. There's been very little rushing room in this game for this East Carolina team. There's just nowhere to go.
You know, they got hit with a haymaker with a big touchdown pass to Renard. You know what? You got time. You can respond. You can get yourself back in this football game. You got to go ahead and not be afraid to open things up to James Pinckney and let him work in the passing game. You're behind. Time is now against you. You got to score, and you got to score quick. But you've got plenty of time to get back in this game. Two scores down.
They have rushed for a grand total of 26 yards and 21 carries. 1.2 yards per rush. Big third down. East Carolina, a whistle on the play. They had five receivers out there, and the flag came in the defensive backfield.
Right snap. Delay of game on the offense. Number seven, five-yard penalty. Remains third down.
He didn't beat the clock.
No, just a little bit too much time in the huddle. And that hole is getting deeper.
And now it'll make it an even longer third down play as it gets moved back. Pirates now have had seven penalties for 85 yards in this game. Maybe none bigger than that one. It does open the field, spread it out a little bit, but it brings up a third down and 14.
And you're trying to convert, but you can't turn the football over here.
Pinckney under rush. Now his arm may have been hit. It's incomplete, intended for Allison on the near side. He got a rush that time, stepped up, but could not connect on it. And they're going to have to turn the football over. Three and out.
Well, you know, I like, everything's fine. You want to run the football, that's fine and dandy. But the way I think if you're East Carolina to run it is you go to the gun, you spread them out, four receivers, maybe a tight end and three receivers, and then run it from that formation because you have West Virginia spread out if you want to line up and go right at them. They've proven in this football game they're not going to allow you to line up in a conventional formation and run the football.
Doherty again averaging over 54 yards with his kicks today. Had a couple of big rolls. That'll be taken at midfield up to the 40. Cut back 35 and a great return by Vaughn Rivers. Good field position for West Virginia. Good return, 36-yard punt, and an 18-yard return. And now the East Carolina defense called on all day to get that football back. Asked to do it again with 9:37 to go. Probably does not surprise you that the Pirates quarterback, James Pinckney, was a quarterback in the backyard. But which one did he play when we come back? 24-10, and they do not have the football in great field position here as the Mountaineers take over again. First down and 10, Slayton. He'll turn it to the 30. Slayton will cut it back and get up to the 25. C.J. Wilson, freshman, moved in on the hit. And Slayton set out much of the third quarter and part of the fourth, now starting to pick his play up again.
Yeah, now you're going to get a belly full of that big offensive line. They're going to turn the game over, and that's what they do. They get up on you, and then late in the football game, they're going to run behind that fabulous offensive line of West Virginia.
Pirate defense had only a minute 52 of rest time between the touchdown on that 60-yard play and the three and out for East Carolina. And that's going to be enough for a first down inside the 20-yard line up to about the 16. Brandon Miles, the senior, On the pass reception, that's good for 11 yards and another first down.
Now, this was entering tonight the top rushers in Division One this season after three weeks, and you see Steve Slayton right there, and he was averaging 113 in the first quarter coming into this football game. Amazing.
This is a little different game for West Virginia, even though they've got the lead. Not the big blowouts that they've had in the first three games over Marshall, Eastern Washington, and last week 45-24 against Maryland. Slayton again on the carry, this time straight ahead, and he's going to lose a yard. The fourth time Slayton has been thrown for a loss in the game, and Flournoy has been in on most of them. Todd Harris.
Well, Gary, here is a prime example of hindsight being 2020. Steve Slayton accepted a scholarship to go play for Ralph Friedgen in Maryland. He was all set to go be a Terp. They pulled his scholarship. Didn't think he'd be worth the scholarship. Had some other backs in that position, so they withdrew the scholarship from him. Here he is now. I wonder how they felt in College Park last weekend.
Not real happy. And boy, did he feel happy.
Oh, yeah.
Good game.
Poetic justice.
A second down and 11. Slayton on the far side to the 20. Again, he's going to go down. And right about at the line of scrimmage for that play. He's not going to get back to the original line of scrimmage. So, Steve Slayton, the sledding has been tough today. This East Carolina defense, they've had to play a lot. But they've had Slayton pretty well covered, especially when he's tried to go wide.
Yeah, I mean, they've done as good a job as anybody in the country of corralling Steve Slayton. And you know, just some turnovers and just missed opportunities have them trailing in this football game by two scores. But I'll tell you what, the defense for East Carolina has played one heck of a football game.
Third down, they run the little screen to the wide side this time, and that's not going to be enough for a first down. Owen Schmidt did a little high hurdle there, got by one tackler, then got caught. It'll be about 4 or 5 yards shy of a first down, and it'll bring up a fourth.
Just watch this, the athletic ability of a big guy, 6'3", 250, who was a former walk-on. Right there. Boom. He loves the collisions. I mean, he wants to hit somebody. He's tearing up face masks and everything. Every week, pretty much, they're changing out his face mask because he's bending them up.
McAfee will come on for the field goal. McAfee is going to attempt a 29-yarder here. And obviously, this is an important 3 points with 6:18 left to go. McAfee's kick is up, and it is through. So they tack on three more. McAfee has got a couple here, two for two, one of 28, now one of 29, and increases that West Virginia lead as they try and go 4-0 to start the season. They are 3-0 now, listed 4 in the nation.
Now here's a hurdle again by Owen Schmidt. Right here, and you see him. Just nice athletic play by big guy, 250 pounds. Tough football player. And that's what his face mask looked like a couple of weeks ago. Right there, just all bent up and smushed in. He said he had a titanium one last week. He smushed that thing in. So, I mean, every week they're having to do a new one. I'm not sure today if he's stuck it on anybody today, but you talk about just a good football player.
Good, tough yardage right there. This team's trying to win their 11th game in a row going back to last year. They are second in the nation in win streaks to the TCU team, the Horned Frogs.
Yep.
Who have won 13 in
a row. Gary Patterson having a heck of a year down there in Fort Worth, Texas.
They will be playing on Thursday as they are off this weekend. So McAfee with a couple of field goals. White has had a 5-yard run. He's had the pass. White to Schmidt early on. White to Renaud for the big 60-yard gain here as the Mountaineers have just kept on charging. And as a result, increase their lead to 27-10. This is the best start for this point in the season that a West Virginia team has ever had in the 113-year history of the program. That'll be taken in the end zone and brought back out to the 20. East Carolina will get a first and 10, but right now their worst enemy is that clock with 6:07 left to go. And the fired up West Virginia sideline as Rodriguez, his sixth season, 42-22, the record that he has put up. Last year they had a tremendous year of 11-1. They've won the Big East three consecutive seasons now and went on to win against Georgia in the Sugar Bowl. That longest active win streak you saw certainly looks like they're going to continue it here. First down and 10, East Carolina. They'll drop that one off under the coverage, 25, 30-yard line, and to the 35 and over, maybe the 37. That is Fractious on the carry, 16-yard gain.
Yeah, it's a nice play call there. A lot of coaches like to screen when it's man-to-man, draw the defense to the quarterback, but you can screen against zone coverage as well. Let the defensive lineman go, get the big lineman up on the linebackers as well as the third level of the defensive secondary and have some success.
They come back with the end coming back from the wide side, Allison. Only three down on this 3-3 defense, and obviously now everybody playing back.
Well, if you're going to run that middle screen, what Andre Allison has to realize is that you can't dance around in the middle of the field because they show up in a hurry. Get the football and get north and south. And that's what Skip Holtz will be telling him during film study tomorrow.
And Allison comes out limping a little bit himself. Brings up a second down and 10. Looking to the near sideline, caught at the 45-yard line. Bobby Good on a nice catch from James Pinckney for 9.
Oh, what a well-thrown football by James Pinckney to Bobby Good. An out route, and it's a tough throw way across the field, but you're going to throw it low and outside right here. Read it, get it out, and you see the position of the football away from the defenders, where your guy's going to catch it or it's an incomplete pass, but he puts that football right where Bobby Good can come up with a catch.
5:09 left to go here in the fourth. He'll keep it this time and takes it up to midfield. Pinckney. That kind of yardage is nice, but it's not going to do any good right here. They do get the first down on it. First down at 10. Clock at 5:04 to go.
Yeah, it's going to stop until they set the chains. Then it'll start to go again. So they've got a little bit of time on their side. But, boy, you got to really start to challenge this West Virginia defense if you're going to get yourself back in this ballgame.
Tough to do when you've got, of course, a solid pass defense. The nickel in there now at the near side 45-yard line and then driven back on a little hook pattern right there. That is complete for about 5 yards. That is Jamar Bryant, who's come into the football game, his first reception.
Freshman mistake right there. Catch it and get out of bounds. Right here, push it off, set it up at 6 yards, catch it, get out of bounds. You're not going to break that thing. Get it out of bounds and stop the clock.
Kept it running instead after the gain of 5. Second down and 5. Picks the low snap up down to the 30-yard line and takes it down to the 28. James Bryant again on the reception. A lot of room under the coverage, obviously, with West Virginia. Their defense playing way back.
We're watching here, just a nice little slant route. You'll see him come inside to your screen here across the middle. Boom. Right on time with the football is James Pinckney.
Looking over the middle, that'll be incomplete. Looking for a little hook pattern there that will stop the clock with 4:13 left to go.
You know, no harm done. You needed to stop the clock anyway, and that looked like a broken play. Get rid of it and come back, huddle up. Just get yourself a nice play call here if you're Skip Holtz and this offense.
East Carolina, they've put up a valiant fight here. They lost to Navy, the UAB, and then beat Memphis 35-20 last week. We're looking to build on that here in this game, but down 27-10. Again, over the middle, it is caught, avoids to the 20, and inside the 15-yard line. Good effort. Bobby Good has had a strong second half. He did not start receiving until late in the first half.
This is what I wanted to see East Carolina go to earlier in this football game, when they had some success in the first quarter throwing the football, and then they kind of went away from it. Spread them out and make them defend. They want to run zone coverage. It's going to be a lot of holes in the zone, and now James Pinckney is finding the holes.
Good's 4 for 35 in receptions, got 15 on that play. Pinckney looking into the end zone. And I think that was an attempted. Nope, the flag is down. I was going to say.
Send him to Hollywood.
Yeah, send him to Hollywood. I think Bryant may have put on a pretty good act right there. He had defenders around him, including Bobby Hathaway, 55, but it looked like he just fell down between them. But he gets the flag.
Yeah, I tell you what, he said that the coach is talking to him.
There's no.
They're going to wave it off. Play. Yeah, they saw right through that one.
The ball was uncatchable. Second down.
No, I don't know about that. I mean, you know, you're throwing a fade pattern, a guy knocks you off. That wasn't an acting job.
You're right.
He actually got knocked off his route. The coaches really like Jamar Bryant. They say he's got the best hands on the team, but that is interference.
Oh, man.
My goodness.
I take it all back. There was no question Bobby Hathaway shoved him, and the ball was in the air. Well, that's a break for West Virginia. Pinckney's got it second down here. Looking, That one bounced not even near the receiver, Andre Allison. And 3:43 remaining to go.
Well, he's had a lot of bad snaps when he was in the gun, and that really just disrupts the timing. Look at it here, right there, having to go down. Now you got to mold the ball, get it up, and then try to get it out to throw a quick pattern. Just throws the timing completely off for the whole play. And that's been happening most of this football game when James Pinckney has gone to the gun.
Todd Wiggenbach was a tackle. He had to move to the center position because of an injury this year. This will be the 10th pass coming up of this drive. And they need that first down. He gets hit. And it's going to be called an incomplete pass. Warren Young, a senior tackle, put the hit on. It's going to bring up a fourth down. Pinckney's going to have some black and blues when this day is done. He has taken some shots back there. They got to go here, trailing 27-10. They can get a first down inside the four. He's thrown for 247 yards passing. 15 consecutive 200.
They hit one in the creases of the defense, and they go three deep zone. All of a sudden, it throws the timing off.
West Virginia leads it 27-10, 3:33 to go in the fourth. The number four team in the nation against the East Carolina team that has played them tough here today.
Yeah, we're thinking right now, West Virginia, you just want to hold on to the football, work some clock, and not turn it over down here inside your own, right inside the red zone.
They got a first down and 10. They're at their own 14-yard line. Slayton on the carry for the fifth time in this football game and has done so successfully. Going to make it even tougher on future opponents of this team. White with a second down, long yardage, 13. Nowhere to go again, this East Carolina defense. Maybe down under 3 minutes left in this game, but for Kyle Chase, who made that tackle and company, they are continuing to drive. They have done themselves proud on defense today.
I'll tell you what, Greg Hudson has done a fabulous job getting his players to play hard for the entire ball game, and I mean they have really fought and stood in there with a high-powered West Virginia offensive football team. There he is right there, the defensive coordinator for East Carolina. Boy, he should be proud of his troops. You know, you talk about it, they gave up 27 points, but sometimes they would just had their backs against the wall with unbearable field position.
Yep. 2:22 left to go in the football game. White will come under center, third and long yardage, going to carry that one. East Carolina.
Be a long evening for Rich Rodriguez in West Virginia.
Protecting the punter, who's going to be all the way back in the end zone here. Scott Kozlowski just gets the line drive, wants the bounce, will get it all the way up to midfield. It will take the bounce for West Virginia. East Carolina will get the football back at their own 41-yard line, but only 2:02 left to go here in the football game.
And they got to hustle out because this clock's going to start. Remember, that's the new rule in college football, change of possession. As soon as they whistle, get the change set, they'll whistle it and the clock will start. So you got to have a play called and be ready at the line of scrimmage.
East Carolina, barring a miracle comeback, will be 1-3 on the start of this season, while West Virginia will be protecting their number four ranking in the nation and will be 4-0 with a win here. And obviously got to put it up in the air. Pinckney looking deep on the sideline. That'll be incomplete. James Bryant again, who's become a target here in the fourth quarter. That'll fall away and stop the clock at a minute 53.
Yeah, if a guy is moving, if he's on the move, you got to take a little bit off the football. If he's planted in a curl route coming right back at you, go ahead, you can zip it in there. But if he's moving away from you laterally, you got to make sure you throw him a football with some touch there. James Pinckney, a little bit too much mustard on.
This will be a second down and 10. Only three rushing they got in there, though. That ball is going to be back onto the team. Out of the ball game, Johnny Dingle. The Crescent at quarterback, rifles one to the 40, flag goes down, driven out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Bryant again there on the reception, and a flag on the near side. 24-yard gain.
And we talked about that big-time arm that he has. I mean, right there on a little corner route, just zipping it in there right away.
Team all the way down to the 23-yard line. He has to handle the low snap as well. That'll be caught for about a 3-yard gain by Philip Henry on the far side. And the clock is running with a minute 29 left to go.
Well, Wiggenbach is just, you know, having some trouble getting those gun snaps back there. It's because he's got a nose guard over him all night long. I mean, right there trying to snap it and then get it back there and pass block all at the same time. A guy right over your face mask the entire night. And it really has disrupted him to the point where it's thrown the timing of the offense off most of this football game.
That'll be the incomplete, stopping the clock.
See the low snap there again. You know, if you got to catch it, get it out fast. That's frustrating. You're right there because you can't catch it, mold it, and get it out. You can't really even get the laces on a lot of times if you're a lace thrower. I was always wanted that lace, right? You want to feel the lace. Aikman always threw the football. He never used a lace.
Amazing, because most quarterbacks, as you say, like yourself, want that for control. Kress fakes. He's going to run it. Third down here. They'll get it down to the 15 and about the 12-yard line. And maybe enough for a first down.
I think he's got it.
Looks like it. 7 for a first down. And he got it.
I mentioned the fact earlier, Skip Holtz, he doesn't really let anyone know who the backup quarterback is. We didn't know who was coming in, whether it was going to be Brent Clay, Robert Cass, or Patrick Pinckney. It turns out it's Rob Cass. This kid looks pretty good so far.
Another minute left to go in the game. 5 receivers. Rob Cass gets hit as he lets that one go, and it'll be incomplete in the end zone. Even with just 3 men rushing, they're getting guys into the backfield. Lewis on the coverage that time in the end zone. And Dykes was the man who put the pressure on the quarterback.
Yeah, that's what makes West Virginia so good, is that they can get pass rush with just 3 guys. They line up, and it's a nose guard and a guy over the tackle on both tackles, and they just come after you, and you chip on them, you block them, but they somehow get in the face of the quarterback enough to disrupt the throw.
Big job when you have only 3 down. 51 seconds left. A second down and 10. Picks it up off the ground, runs into a blocker, turns near side to the 10, and will be taken down at the 9-yard line. So Cass gets 3 on the carry, and that is Kevin McLee who took him down.
Well, he'll mature into that, figuring that, well, it's better to, at this point, throw it away or get myself out of bounds and stop the clock.
It's still running at 26 seconds right now. Cass again looking. That is going to be incomplete. Bryant, the intended receiver. Amazing thing about this West Virginia defense, they had only 1 defensive back returning as a starter, and that was McLee, number 43. They are fairly young in that defensive backfield, and yet, as you've seen the way they've played in this game, they've done a pretty good job. Came in 33rd in the nation against the pass on defense, 55 against the rush. You've seen Quentin Andrews, freshman. They say he's got a big future out there now.
They really, really like him a lot. And it's a young secondary, 2 juniors out at the corner positions, and redshirt freshman and a sophomore at the safety.
That's going to be incomplete. Flag goes down. With their victory here, West Virginia is going to be loving the month of September. It'll be their 12th. Straight win in games played in September. Talk about good starts.
Pass interference on the defense. Number 3. Ball will be placed at the spot of the infraction. Automatic. First down.
Not happy with the penalties, even with the lead late in the game. As he's trying to keep his team away from that. James Pinckney getting his arm wrapped with ice over there. 18 seconds left to go. Cass trying to take him in for a touchdown. Lobs one into the corner for Bryant. That is incomplete. Again on the coverage, Antonio Lewis, who's been a busy cornerback in this game and has done an exceptional job. 19 tackles for him, one of their leading tacklers, as well as a pass defender.
You know, when you come in and you face the number 4 team in the country like this, and it's such a talented football team, West Virginia, you got to have some breaks go your way, and you can't make mistakes at unopportune times. And that's what's happened to East Carolina in this football game. They didn't get the breaks, the big punt return where it was fumbled. They didn't come up with that. And all of a sudden, West Virginia, they go down and score, and you find yourself playing from behind.
That is going to be intercepted. Lewis in the end zone, and with 7 seconds left to go, that's going to do it for West Virginia. And we should note in that first half, that was a ball that was inside the 10-yard line of the Mountaineers, that if East Carolina had recovered on the punt return, they would have had it inside the 10. The East Carolina player tried to pick it up and score on it. You can't do that in college ball on a punt like that that's mishandled. So if they'd just fallen on it, they would have had the football. They didn't. And at that point, it could have been a turning play in the game.
I think so, because at worst, you're looking at 14-10 instead of being down 14-7.
And that's going to do it. So East Carolina gave it a gallant effort, but the number 4 West Virginia team comes away with a 27-10 win. The